Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. So I have a question for you. Why do you suck at parsing JSON? Well, we're gonna get into that, as well as if you'd like to support the channel. Let's get into this. Here's some of the imports we're gonna do today if you'd like to follow along. There's a few things I think you should think about when you're looking at parsing JSON files. For instance, there's a few tools or techniques that you should be aware of first. JSON Normalize and Pandas Explode. Those are two things that you should get in your tool belt. Then the next things you should start looking at. Do you have a list of dictionaries? Do you have nested objects? Are your dictionary values a list? If you're doing web scraping or using an API, you could do some pre-processing ahead of time. Are you using a data frame to parse, or are you iterating beforehand? I decided to choose the New York Times API once again because there's a few examples in this that will go over a few techniques. I keep getting people coming up with similar circumstances, and I decided to try to go through this as slowly as I can to reinforce some techniques when you're looking at your data. Every situation is different. You need to understand that. You may have values such as this, which are lists. Your values may be further dictionaries. Depending on how that's set up would dictate how you're going to parse these data, all right? When you're calling this request, if you're using an API or if you're doing any web scraping, you could convert this into text. The good thing about using this JSON right here, we could start parsing by using our keys to extract what we may need. You're gonna see that all of the values are different. These are just strings. For these, some of them are empty, some of them are dates. Depending on what you need to do for processing will dictate how you handle these. When you call this request for the API that you see highlighted right here, let's zoom in a little bit, you're going to notice that we can iterate through this variable that we just created called JSON text and find the outermost keys. Of interest for us right now is this results section because the rest are just junk. Since we know what that outermost key is, we could then iterate inside of that, append it to a list, throw it into a data frame, and see what we get. We notice that we have these news articles, and we could scroll over, and we could see that we have these columns here, which are lists. Some of them are empty, some of them are strings, some of them are further dictionaries. We'll take these specific columns and practice a few skills. Instead of iterating like I did above, I directly called that outermost key and threw it into a data frame, which will give us the same exact thing. Now, when you're iterating, instead of doing that data frame, there's situations where you can actually parse your data directly. It just depends on how these formats are with inside of it. First thing we're going to look at is what do we do with the columns that are still the list? Let's investigate that and only pull those columns so we could do some formatting and get a little bit of practice. Understand everyone's data looks different and you have to adapt and learn different techniques along the way. I've made around 13 videos at this point doing various JSON parsing, creating functions, nested parsing, etc. I made those because you have various techniques and situations that come up. I can't cover everything in one video. So we have these columns that are just our list of strings and dictionaries, an empty list. What do we do with this? The first thing you need to be aware of is the pandas explode, which flattens out your list. But notice something. These lists are in varying lengths. So when you try to explode these, you're going to have an issue if you do it all at once because they're not the same length. You're going to get a value error. Just look at this. From what I was just mentioning, this is the function you need to be aware of to flatten out these lists. But when you do this, you're going to create more rows. You need to be aware of that. And it's going to be indexed with where it expanded from. And you'll see that in a second. Because you need to understand this is a little bit different. You're working with more than one column of varying sizes. If we were to use this apply function to use the explode on each column, you get the value error that I'm talking about. If they were all the same length of list, we'd be fine. We adapt this a little bit in a few easy lines of code. Super easy. What I decided to do, zoom in just a little bit, is I took those columns of interest and instead I iterated one by one for each one of those column names and I did the explode on it each individual time and then I updated the data frame. So it went through the first column, did the explode. Then it went through the second column and updated that. Let me show you what's really going on here so you can get an idea. Let's comment all this out real quick. We're going to say that we want to do this on one particular column. We updated this column, and now we have more rows that you're going to see right here. But all of these other columns are the same. Now, the next thing we do is go through this one, remove this list, this one, remove the list, this one, remove the list, and go one by one by one by one, doing an update. So you don't need to do any kind of recursive steps or anything like that. You don't need to make this more complicated. Doing this line of code is great because it just updates each time you go through iterating each column. So you'll notice that we got everything done. So now the only thing that we need to do is deal with this, which will use the JSON normalize, which will flatten out this and give us a dot notation on this media. So we use the JSON normalize, but we need to work inner to outer. First thing we do is we convert our data frame into a JSON object, and then we use JSON.loads, which is converting this to a string. And then we're using the pandas.json normalize function so we can flatten out that dictionary. And if you notice this, you get this dot notation here for each key that it extracted in that nested dictionary of dictionaries. That's what you pull out here. And when you scroll over, it looks like we're pretty good. You only have this here. Really, if you wanted to expand that, you could expand and get more URLs. But I left this because I just felt it wasn't necessary. The next thing that I wanted to do is show you, what if our values are, instead of lists or just strings, they're more dictionaries. And inside of that dictionary, you have values that are now a list of more dictionaries. I've done this type of stock data before, but I set this up with two examples so you can see what this is looking like when you're parsing it, so it's a little more realistic. So you have quite a bit of key value pairs here. We have two entries. When we throw this into a data frame, we notice that we have this outermost key, which is our chart. Then the next key is the result that we want to deal with. And then we have to figure out, what do we do with this list of further dictionaries? We'll be able to use it, pandas explode once again. So instead, I decide, what about iterating through the first two keys and throwing this out as a data frame to get us closer and avoiding having to do any JSON normalize yet? And you notice that we have this metadata, and we have to say, well, how do we deal with this now? Because this is a lot closer to what we need, but not completely there. So at this step, we're going to use the JSON normalize. Since we're dealing with a list, I had to go inside of it and use an apply function so we can go over these as columns. We end up with our two examples that we have, which is our timestamp information and all these other columns. Each one of these dot notations deals with each individual nested dictionary. Since everything fell within this metadata, which is this, you get meta currency, meta symbol, meta currency, meta symbol, etc. You have all of these columns. Now we have these last three columns here, which are lists that we need to further investigate. This column is pretty useless, as well as these two, if you've watched the other video I've done before. We're going to use the same things we did with the pandas explode to get rid of the first part, which is the list. I drop those useless columns, and then I provide the same thing that I did in the first example, doing an update, going over each individual column and doing an explode if it was a list. Remember, we're creating more rows. So we could scroll over and see that we're pretty much there, and you would only need now to do a JSON normalize. So at that point, pardon the made up variable name, but we're pretty much there. And you'll notice that we have these list of values that we need to take care of. Well, when you have those list of values, you just do your pandas explode. We are able to use this formatting to go over all columns using the pandas explode because they're the same length. We do not get a value error and don't have to do any weird formatting or iteration trickery that we did above. That's why this one will work. As you see here, we scroll over, and now you'll see that we flattened out our nested portions, and now we have our open, adjusted, close, volume, and close. But that's the end of this video. I would like to say, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. Feel free to help support this channel so I could continue making content for you on Patreon, or feel free to buy me a coffee. Don't forget to hit me up on Twitter and Instagram. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.